Jevamayishe kitasauhidartha jane shudehan tarvartikeshu gehe suyayatma jarati matsu na priti yukta javadarthas chaloke Jevamayishe kitasauhidartha jane shudehan tarvartikeshu Gehe shayayat majarati matsu na priti yukta javadartha shaloke Gauriya Goshtipati Sisila Bhakti Siddhanto Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told those who are speaking, we like to lead our life very peacefully, don't disturb me. Gauriya Goshtipati Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told those who are going to speak that we like to lead our life very peacefully, tranquil life, don't try to disturb us. Srila Saraswati Thakur speaking, obviously, surely, they have passive calm inside their heart. 100% they have passive calm inside their heart. Otherwise, how they can speak this way? Whereas we see that they have come to do Gauriya Bhajan. What is the secrecy of Gauriya Bhajan? Srila Saraswati Thakur speaking, those who are going to seek some peaceful situation, they have no desire to serve Supreme Lord. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur, to teach us a nice lesson, singing in Kirtan, Tomar Shevai Dukha Hai Yato Sehota Param Sukh. Any amount of trouble, any amount of problem can come in my life in the way of your bhajan. I can accept it. I invite all problem to come in my life. But still, I am not going to deviate from the track shown by my Sadguru. There is the only motto of a genuine devotee. That's why we find, because there we find, Jeva Moishe Kito Sauhirdartha. Sauhardo mean priti, prem. I can discuss this secret tatta, prema tatta. We can compare it with love? Not at all possible. We cannot use this word love. You are foolish. You don't understand what I mean to say, prema. Actually, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada speaking, that those who are dedicated soul unto the lotus feet of Sadguru, in the lime of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they actually always want to serve Supreme Lord under the guidance of Guru, Sadguru Vaishnava. Yesterday I was speaking a scientific description of what is called Ekayan Paddhati, unique Ekayan Paddhati. Ekayan Paddhati, yes. Vedas are Ekayan Paddhati, coming through one channel. Any kind of seva, any kind of, you know, we have any kind of quality, any kind of seva, that should be channelized through a proper channel of Guru Parampara and go up to that line. Slightly if I deviated, then I can grow false ego. Who are you? What do you know? This kind of mentality can touch me and kill me. Kill me? Yes. Spiritual death is actual death. You are crying in front of me, Maharaj, how I can bear this kind of strong speech? If you cannot digest, you will have to take more medicine. I mean digestive medicine, so that you can ultimately digest, but I cannot compromise. Now my first question is that, who is going to save you? My first question in front of you, who is going to save you? Your father, your mother, your friends, who is going to save you? those who are going to show your love, so-called love, having some nice relationship with you, they can save you. So you should think over and again. That's why in Bhagavatam we find Gurur na sasyat, sajjanu na sasyat, pita na sasyat, na sajjanani na sasyat, daivam na sasyat, patim na sasyat, na mochayat ja samapeta mittum. Who cannot save me from imminent death? I can see my death. You cannot see, you are blind. You cannot see, your death is standing in front of you. You have to see, face. Then you cannot speak that kind of question in front of you. I am sure. You cannot see your death. That's why you are speaking this way. Life is very short. Nobody going to save me, nobody going to save me. No father, no mother, no husband, no wife, no demigods. Nobody can save me. Maharaj, we heard Shankar Bhagavan can save. Yes, Shankar Bhagavan can, but not directly. Kasi Maranat Mukti. If you die in Kasi, it is the duty of Shankar Bhagavan to speak Mahamantra, Tarak Brahma Mantra in your ear. And gradually, in next life and this, gradually you can have the chance to do bhajan. Gradual mukti, not direct mukti. Mukti data Vishnu Deva Nasansayo. No doubt that Vishnu is the only personality who can give mukti. And actually, we can discuss this point after. So, nobody can save me. What can save me? Only prema. I can discuss over common days, coming days. Nobody can save me, no father, no mother, no husband, nothing, no sister, nobody. Any amount of your money, any amount of your, you know, education, any amount of your manpower, just unable to give you full protection in this material life. Protection means not bodily protection. You can have the chance to stay nicely, lead your life, material life. I am not speaking about that kind of spiritual protection. When we can find nobody is there behind us to protect us, when we can find nobody there to protect me, then surely it's a great danger. What do you mean? Popat mean to say, if there is no perceptor, Sadguru, who can protect me from imminent danger, then surely I am going to get lost in this infinity world. If you get lost in infinity world, where is innumerous jivatma, countless, for infinity period, if you go on counting how much jivatma, you cannot count. If you get lost in this infinity universe, where I can go to search you? Where is my daughter gone? Where I can go to search you? If you are going to miss this chance, where I can go to search you? You can get lost. But one point, if you have some relationship with pure Vaishnava, especially Diksha, Shiksha, then the Siddhanta is there. Apparently, if you get lost, someday you can come and again that Sadguru can catch you and pull you up. That's why Parambuja Siddhar Goswami used to speak this way, appropriate Siddhanta. If you have any genuine relationship with, no duplicity, relationship with Guru Vaishnava, He is going to save you. Diksha dan dilo jai janme janme prabhu se. What do you mean? What is the explanation of this word? What is the explanation of this word? Bhaktivinoda Thakur writes, diksha dan dilo jai janme janme guru se. Who has given me diksha out of his causeless mercy? He has shown matchless, mercy on me. Janme janme guru se, same guru. I get Srila Bhakti Prabhupada Purigashima this life. Then if I am not successful, next life, same guru can come to you, foolish. Don't understand guru tattva. What is the main reason of fighting all around the world, you know? Same thing. Excuse me. Same thing. They don't understand tattva vijnan. How they can understand? They are busy with fighting. Patishtha, position, they are busy. But even in Niti Shastra it is written. In Niti Shastra, not in our spiritual. In Niti Shastra, if you find one nice thing, very beautiful teaching from a very externally very, poor man. Poor man means the saying is no money, no position, nothing. Still will have to. Jukti yuktam pargniyat balat opi. Even one small boy is speaking very nice. These were wise men. This small boy, a boy of 8 years old, 10. Wait. Small boy, 8 years age, 10, is speaking. Wait. But it's a very gravity of this word. Same thing again, so example. When Krishna Balaram speaking in front of Nanda Baba, Yasodama, all everybody there, all senior personality, with appealing mood, why you are doing Indra Puja? What benefit you can get? Then gradually with this appealing mood, wanted to explain the topmost secrecy of Vedanta. You will have to go to a right source to get all this knowledge, not here and there. But I cannot check you. That's why I cannot save you. But I can save you. It is not my power, by the power of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Guru Bhargava. Actually, Krishna Balaram, very small boy, giving very advice, very appealing mood. Pita, at all we are grateful. We should be grateful for the Supreme Lord who is arranging everything. Who is Indra actually to grant rain or anything, any kind of? And at all we should worship this Giriraj Maharaj. Why? It's Giriraj Maharaj giving us actually hill for we are coward boy, we are coward man going with all cows and in the hills. And due to the Giriraj Maharaj, and they're pulling these clouds, and we are getting rain properly. We are getting so much creepers and very nice fruits and flowers there. And posturing ground where Gomata can move around. So at least if we like to worship, we should worship Giriraj. We should be grateful. Gratefulness is a main thing. If I ignore your love, then I am not Vaishnava. Perhaps you have heard one word, you can remember. Cleanliness is next to godliness. I was laughing. In station this word was there. Cleanliness is next to godliness. I say, they are foolish actually. They are writing, but they don't know the inner meaning of this. They are writing rightly. Cleanliness means external cleaning. But as soon as you see, this is right saying, they are speaking right, maybe some material people write, but it's right. Cleanliness means, if my heart is clean, I can think about it, Chetadarpana Mahaprabhu, I am teaching. It is next to godliness. I can come, I can get the smell of Supreme Lord. I can approach gradually, great green signal gradually. So, really so. Actually, but they don't know meaning. So this way, Krishna Balaram going to speak very humble way, the actual mode of worship, why and how we should worship. Though at the time of Govardhan Puja, Harikatha, I was explaining, at all if they are going to worship Indra Maharaj, that is also bhakti. At all I am going to do Indra Maharaj, it's not bhakti. You have to go through Harikatha repeatedly. Why I explain this way? At all they are going to receive Indra, Vrajavasi, still it is bhakti. How, Maharaj? I will have to explain because you have to understand the Raganuga Bhajan secrecy, because today is the Madhavendra Puripad day. I am bound to speak that way. Why it is bhakti? Why Sachimata when worshipping Sastima, one demigod, demigoddess, still it is bhakti? That book is being translated. You can go mad. You can sit, cannot sit in chair. You can laugh and dance. I am trying my best. So nice, I published this 12 years back, maybe. Together with Sampradaya, if there is no Parampara Sampradaya in our, that is in Bengali, Nimai for Nimai, small Nimai, or 4, 5, 6 books at a time I published that year, 12 years back. Follow? So there it is written, Sachima is praying to Sastima. Sastima is one kind of demigod, Devi, Devi. One form of Durga, you can speak that way. She is taking special care of small children. They are suffering, this, that, naughty boys. Sastima bless, then the boy become peaceful and healthy. That's why Sachima going to worship the Sastima. Today Nimai is not there going for playing. It's a nice opportunity. I can make some cake and, you know, nice, you know, and boga. I can take it. Nimai is not there. If Nimai is there, they can disturb me. For morning time, gone to play. There's the opportunity. Packing everything, fruits and flour, and cake, everything in a pot, taking and going for Sasti Puja. Sasti Puja, Sasti Tala. In the meantime, Nimai calling, Mother, where you are going? He coming, hey, he's coming. You go to Rome. I'm coming, you go to home. No, where you are going? And what is there in your hand? Nothing, you go. You go, I'm coming, just coming. I can give you. Go. Now I like to see what is there in your hand. Ultimately, Nimai coming, without cloth, small boy, opening the cloth and taking the cake and eat. Oh my God, all Uchista, how Sosti can give, how I can give, oh Sostima. You are giving to Sostima? Eh? If I take Sostima, oh my God, Sostima, excuse my small boy, you know nothing. That's why speaking that way. If I take, oh Sostima, I become very happy. Don't speak that way. You see, what is a tremendous love? What is the abnormal, tremendous love for the boy? They already know when childhood, what is the footprint of, they know. They getting already indication, the Supreme. Still they, out of their strong love and affection, they forget the Supreme. It's my boy, small one, naughty boy. Can you grow that kind of feeling? You can grow that kind of feeling? That kind of feeling is. So when Nanda Maharaj going to receive, at all, when Nanda Maharaj is going to receive Indra, that is also bhakti. Because at all, what they are going to do, that is for the good of Krishna and Krishna's dham. Follow my point. What is the secrecy of Raganuga Bhajan? At all, if they are going to do anything, all you can go back to the original cause, they can find love for Krishna and Krishna's dham, Vrindavan. Nothing else. And what we all doing, all for a personal interest. That's why we cannot do proper bhajan. Somebody can motivate you to serve some maya seva. Oh, Maharaj speaking, I can go. Better I can stop Harikatha. It's good. Okay. This way, we are busy with Maya Seva all the time. So, actually point is that the sloka I started is very important. Jeva Moishe Krita Sauhidartha. Those who are having some strong love for me, my boys, Rishabh is speaking in front of those 100 boys. Jeva Mai Ishe, Jeva Mai Ishe, Kito Sauhidartha, Jani Sudehantaravartikeshu. They are less interested about what is happening all around the world. They have no time to criticize anybody. But surely they can establish Siddhanta. Regarding Siddhanta, they cannot go back because they are in a position to represent Absolute Truth. That's why Prabhupada was speaking, always speaking, I am acting as Acharya, so it is my duty 100% to establish Siddhanta. At all, if there is any Siddhanta Virodhi is there, they will have to rectify. It is the duty of an Acharya. So, Prabhupada always speaking, those Vrajavasis, they are Mathur Viraha Vrajavasis, to serve them is our ultimate goal. Mathur Viraha Vrajavasi, Mathur Viraha, you know, Mathur Viraha. Mathuranath, they are speaking with loveful, angry attitude. Angry to loveful? Yes. Loveful, angry attitude. Now you are Mathuranath, you forget about us. And actually, it is written, Prabhupada speaking, Mathur Viraha Vrajavasigan, Mathur Viraha Vrajavasigan. Krishna is no more there at present, gone to Mathura. So their nickname Mathuranath, Mathur, Mathur Viraha, Prema, a deep feeling of separation. Deep feeling of separation. You cannot even imagine. Now, first of all, I want to give you a reminder that if you are going to realize this point, nobody in this infinity universe can save me. Only Guru Vaishnava and Bhagavan can save me. Guru Vaishnava can save me. Brahmanda Bhamite Gono Bhagavan Jeev Guru Vishnu Prasade Pai Bhakti Lata Vich. Only they can save me. So it is your duty to follow the instruction of Guru Vaishnava perfectly. Of course, if Guru Vaishnava is going to make some new Siddhanta manufacturing in his brain, I am not speaking about. Were all Siddhanta coming in line? I am a postman going to post the letter that I get in your name. So I am going to your address to hand over the letter to you. You should not be angry with me. For speaking this hard, you should think that Maharaj getting this letter from me is so giving to you. Hari Katha, oh Maharaj, so hard, Hari Katha, so sweet. You should not speak that way. What kind of medicine is required? That is the duty of a doctor. Who are you to prescribe that Maharaj you will have to give soft medicine? Then surely you are not going Guru Vaishnava Tattva. Guru Vaishnava so merciful, that's why they are bound to speak strong way. Prabhupada speaking, we'll have to charge dynamite. A heart is so strong, it has become like Bajra. Vishwanath Chakudhi gave him. Different kind of layers can be there over your realization, direct realization. What is that? Kardam lep, some mud. Ah, only water you can little bit clear. Dhuli lep, first is dhuli, powder, dust part. If you put one mirror, Long time in a room, you can find long, after 1 year or 6 months, all dust on the room. On the mirror, we cannot see. Well, it's very easy. With one cloth, you can. That's called dhuli lep. Dhuli lep, covering up dust particle, covering up mud. That is also, you will have to take a little bit trouble. You have to get some water, clean it. Dhuli lep, kardam lep, postar lep. Postar, you know, stone. What do you know? How long you are hearing Harikatha? So that you can digest this katha? So kardam lep, dhuli lep, kardam lep, you know, postar lep, vajra lep. That's why Prabhupada is speaking. We should charge dynamite of Harikatha to fracture and clean the covering of the heart. But you become very angry. What is this? Guru Vaishnava is a doctor, Baba Vaidya. They can give sweet medicine or they can be bitter medicine. That's according to prescription, you will have to accept it. You have no right to express some agitation against them. You have no right. They think it necessary, that's why applying this medicine. To give exact cure and to make you cure. That's why they are begin. That's why often Prabhupada used to speak that if I want to get that absolute truth, in that case, I will have to follow genuine Guru Vaishnava, realize all. If I seek the path leading to the absolute good, then I must ignore the countless voices of popular wisdom there and follow that of the realized soul. That is why Prabhupada repeatedly wanted to arrest you and check you up. Come here, come, don't go there. I know you are feeling sorry, but still come here. There is no mercy. You can think they are merciful. No. They are murderer. They are not going to show mercy. You don't know the actual meaning of mercy. If at all I am going to show mercy and you are going to accept it, there is no cause of fall down. You can go up. Mercy means, Prabhupada explaining, not to speak sweet speech in front of public. Mercy means to unveil the covering there. Mercy means to take them, arrest them and come and put them in line so that go and realize their own self. Who are you? What is your you know, identity actual? Prabhupada speaking, that is actually called mercy. Mercy doesn't mean that I can give you 1 lakh rupees, you are very poor. Mercy doesn't mean that I can give you a paramanna and puspanna. You can take, oh Maharaj giving me so much prasadam. It's not mercy. You don't know the actual definition of mercy, that's why you are sorry. That's why you cannot understand. That's why all Gaudiya devotees from Gaudiya Math and Gaudiya Mission, same thing. At present they are using this name, that is different. I am speaking about their ideal thing. The mission is said by Prabhupada. So, they all giving their blood and whole energy, the total energy, for the entire satisfaction of the Supreme Lord. They are not going to seek even a drop of self-interest for them. They are going to sing the glories of Supreme Lord all the time. How they are going to preach, with what mood? Before sannyas, you should know this point. Because Krishna Bhagavan speaking, those who are going to take renounce order sannyasis, they should think, whole world is my children. Even one insect, even one insect and worm, my children. International father, universal father, not international. But they are not getting that kind of, who can get that kind of mood? Sannyas man, you are dedicated, you have taken a vow to go up to that level, shown by Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada in our line, and to show mercy to all. Don't become merciless to criticize anybody. When Prabhupada speaking, when somebody going to say, he is not, he is doing this, all wrong activities, he is doing this, that. Prabhupada speaking, when somebody going to indicate and speaking this way, then Prabhupada speaking, then I think, maybe he has done a great bhajan, that's why he is going to find fault with others. Otherwise, who is he to find fault with others? He can do his own duty under the guidance of Guru Vaishnava. Only pure Guru Vaishnava, they are up to that level. They have their 100% right to speak heavily, to cut Siddhanta, wrong Siddhanta, to establish, because they are merciful. They have no envious attitude at all. Heart is so clear. They can do it. All common people cannot do. That's why Prabhupada used to speak this way. Parasabhava karmani na prasangsat na garhet. Be careful. Parasabhava karmani, don't try to criticize others. Maharaj, I am not criticizing, I am praising. Don't praise. Praising not, why? But parasabhava karmani na prasangsat na garhet. You are going to praise or you are going to criticize. Both dangerous. Yes, both dangerous. Dangerous, why? I am praising. Yes, praising. When you are praising your friend, my friend is very good, giving my company, we are leading our life, then you are concentrating on your friend, his qualities, material qualities. Follow my point. When you are going to praise your friends, surely you are going to imagine in your mind your friend is much qualities there. I love him very much. Then you are concentrating on a material object. That is the cause of your bondage. Praising. And criticizing also. When I am going to criticize somebody, that can also contaminate my heart. I cannot maintain purity. But pure Guru Vaishnava, all the time they are pure. Because they have no enmity. They are going to speak this way. Why? To set the situation, which is already upset. That is their only duty. They are discharging the duty given by Supreme Lord. Follow? When Jiva Goswami Pad is going to break the Siddhanta of Ramanuja Charger, that doesn't mean that Jiva Goswami Pad is going to fight with Ramanuja. With full respect, be careful. With full respect, Jiva Goswami was speaking, this Siddhanta we cannot accept because in our Gauriya Bhajan, because we have our bhajan, more filtered bhajan, I can show you. Up to this point, we have to go and see the case. Ramanujaji is not responsible. Okay. He has gone up to this point, so from there, absolute can be seen this way. But Gauriya devotee is Sanatana Rupa Goswami, more up. Naturally, we cannot criticize. With this mentality, with this mood, appealing mood, Jiva Goswami is saying, this Siddhanta is not applicable in our world. It's applicable in their own. That doesn't mean Jiva Goswami is going to insult. You should understand the mood of Guru Vaishnava. Very fine mood, accurate mood. Otherwise, nobody going to discuss. So you see, parasabhava karmani na prasangsad na garhet. Because anyway you are going to concentrate on his good quality or bad quality, you can get deviated because you are weak. If you beat a Guru Vaishnava, pure Guru Vaishnava, beat heavily, but still you cannot change his opinion. Still you cannot change his Siddhanta. Once spoken, spoken. You have your money power, you can put me in torture, cannot change. They are going to give their life. Because Siddhanta means unchangeable. Like one bow and arrow in hand, putting the arrow. Arrow gone, up to the target. If you like to get back the arrow again in, no. One speech gone out of the mouth of a pure Guru Vaishnava, all vital. Maybe you are angry, so what? All like bow and arrow. Gone, gone. You cannot take back. Maybe a whole agitation can start against me. That kind of rigidity should be there in you. Otherwise, how you can do this kind of bhajan? How we can expect to do bhajan? Foolish. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, dhirota, saralota and nirapekshata, those are the three vital quality must have. All other qualities there in Vaishnava. I cannot count. Countless qualities are there. Bhār Bhaktivinoda was speaking, these three qualities, readily you can see. Saralata means simplicity. Straightforward, no duplicity. Antare vahire samavyavahar amani manad havo. Those who are amani manad, not going to expect any kind of garland of any kind of pratishtha, only they and they can speak about their absolute. Nobody else in this infinity world. Be careful, this Siddhanta. Only he can speak. So saralata means not duplicity. Saralata doesn't mean foolishness. Saralata means what is there in heart, he is speaking directly. What is not there realization and not there in heart, he is speaking, he is a cheater. That realization is not there inside you. You are speaking about Raganuga Bhajan. Who are you to speak about Raganuga? You cheater? How you can speak? You have to speak first ABC. And so? So what realization is not there inside your heart? You cannot speak dry philosophy. It is one kind of cheating. Direct realization is there, by the mercy of Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Guru Bhargava, that you can speak in fault of those so-called devotees or public. So, this is a most vital point. Parasabhava karmani na prasayinsayana. Why? Parasabhava karmani na prasayinsayana garahit. Vishwam ekat pakam paschana pakriti purusena cha. As per Sankha Yoga, by the mutual effort of Prakriti and Purush, by the mutual effort of Prakriti and Purush, you can get this soul creation full of Maya. If you are not established in Advaigan Tattva, each and every step you are going to meet with trouble, problem, each and every step, trouble waiting for you. You can see a nice, beautiful girl there. A nice, young, handsome boy there. There's so much appearances. I must go. I can speak Hari Katha there. But there is no so many people. Why we should go there? I cannot get name and fame, position, money, nothing. Follow. That means bonded stage. It's called bonded stage. They are searching their own facility. It's bonded stage. What is bonded stage? What is not bonded stage? So Prakriti and Purush jointly making this. Purush, two type of Purush. In the meantime, I should not speak because I have no time to speak so many things. Purush, two type of Purush. One is there, inside your heart, as Paramatma, is Param Purush, and the form of Paramatma there. Another Purush is there, Actually, the meaning of Purush, you know, the meaning of Purush means having some, you know, ego. I am the doer. This is called Purush. So in this way, all jiva in this world, they are Purush. Follow? They are doership they have. But animals, they can don't understand, especially for human beings available, applicable. So, they are always feeling that I have done, I have given nice lecture. This way their bonded condition can put them in trouble. So all jivatma, those who are, they have some false ego, doership, that is called purushaha. And this material body given to you for this reason, because some karma fall you have to get some karma fall, that's why material body given. So material body, panchabhautik body. So the meaning of purusha is a pure dehe basati iti purushaha. Purushaha not mean gents and ladies. Purush mean usually, you know, this purush and gents and ladies, not that. Purusha mean pure, mane within this world. Pur mane mandir, temple. Pur, the material. Pure dehe basati jivatma iti purushaha. And in this pur, in this temple also, Paramatma is there. So two purusha. One purusha, his false ego is totally false. His ego is totally false. Another purush, his ego is not false. He really is almighty, all-pervading Supreme Lord. His ego is not false. So he is okay. When I speak, I am the servant of Bhakti Bhavan Puri Goswami Maharaj, maybe I am a cheater. If someday I can express this mood with heart, really I am not speaking to, going to speak lie. Then it is called very nice false ego. I am Krishna Das. I am the servant of Krishna. If you can feel this point someday, then your ego is perfect ego. That's why Hanumanji Maharaj, when Ravan asking, hey, who you are? Monkey? Who you are? So, Hanumanji started thinking what to speak because he is Tamaguna. Ravan, what identity I can... Then Sita Devi, coming in fine form, in ear. Why not you speak, you are the servant of Rama? Oh, really? Mother coming and speaking. But Hanumanji think, you are my mother. Hanumanji always speaking this way. Sita Ma, I am my mother, I am your soul. Sita Devi speaking this, why not you speak that you are the servant? Oh, really so? Really, I am the servant? Then speaking in front of Ravan, I am the servant of Rama. Ha 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 ha, Ravan laughing. You are servant? You are so powerful, I thought you were a king of any country, but you are actually servant. Yes, I am servant. I am the servant of Rama. You are the servant of Maya Devi. That is a different. I am servant. I am servant of Rama. But you are servant of Maya Devi. That is a different. Why you are laughing? Why you are laughing? That's why Hanumanji Maharaj started joking. Ravan sitting in throne, Hanumanji Maharaj started enlarging his tail. Making tail, then Ravan looking. Hey! This way. Ultimately giving order, we can set fire to his tail with cloth and, you know, kerosene, everything. Hanumanji Maharaj is very good. Very good opportunity for me. He is very tranquil. After that, when they set fire, Hanumanji Maharaj started laughing, jumping throughout Lanka and set the whole Lanka in fire. Whole Lanka burning. Whole Lanka burning. Hanumanji Maharaj responsible. You give fire, after jumping, whole Lanka. Then somebody asking, Hanumanji Maharaj, you are great Vaishnava. You are going to kill the whole, you know, Lanka burning. How you are doing? You are Vaishnava. I have done no mistake. I am not going to do any jivhingsa. You have done. Why you fire? I am the servant of Ram. I am bound to discharge my duty as a servant of Ram. In the meantime, if anything going to happen, the Ram is... Now we come to the point of Yukta Vairagya. Again, I can explain. The life of Madhavendra Puripad. Follow. Hanumanji Maharaj expressing Yukta Vairagya. Sometimes praying unto the lotus feet of Ram and Lakshan. Sometimes speaking, Prabhu, you can come on my soldier. Ram here, Lakshman here, then flying. Yukta Vairagya. Follow. You have to understand. Very, very nice point. So we cannot run here and there. Repeatedly I told this point. In the name of Sat Sanga, if you are running here and there to do little bit of Sat Sanga, I have no way to protect you. I cannot protect you. I have no way. So you must be very sincere to understand all points, how to lead your life, where to go and not to go. Because both I cannot allow you to run. Satsanga and Asatsanga, both I can run, Maharaj. No. It's not at all allowed to do Satsanga, Asatsanga. So Prakriti Purushena Cha, the Purush is actually two, but the real identity is I am the Ram Das. Jive Sarupai Krishna Nitya Das. If you can realize this point, that is called actual mukti. As per Gauriya Siddhanta, what do you mean by mukti? If you are established in your sharup of Krishna Dasya, servitorship, that is called actually mukti. So mukti, as per Gauriya Darshan, what you can say? Muktir hitva annatha rupam, muktir hitva annatha rupam sarupena vavastiti iti mukti. It's called mukti. Try to understand, you are the servant of Sadguru. If at all, if you find some problem in Guru Parampara, immediately we'll have to take shelter of a very nice, powerful Shiksha Guru, who can act as a compensating factor and give you power again. That's why Jiva Goswami told, na? That's why Jiva Goswami told, you have no right to discriminate between Supreme Lord and His devotees. We cannot say that way. Because all one tattva. How I can criticize devotees? How I can criticize devotees? All one tattva, na? I have no right to criticize. Tattva is one and single, but coming in different form. So, Prabhupada speaking this way, that you have to be very careful about Guru Vaishnava Tattva. And Jiva Goswami is giving warning, the Tattva Acharya, topmost Tattva Acharya in your Gaudiya society. In infinity world, you cannot find that kind of Pandit. You cannot find, matchless. He is speaking, Gurvagaya tat sevan avirodena cha annesha mopi vaishnavanam sevanam sreya. Jiva Goswami is speaking. You have no right to cut this Siddhanta, speak wrong Siddhanta. Gurvagaya by the permission of Gurudev, not disturbing the main Guru Seva, if at all he is Sadguru, I am speaking that point. Gurvagaya, at all he is Sadguru. Gurvagaya tat sevan avirodena cha. Annesha mopi vaishnavan sevanam. If I am going to serve Siddhar Goswami Maharaj, my Guru Maharaj will become very happy. You are going to serve Siddhar Maharaj? I heard from Gurudev, I am in Vyasasan, my son, if you serve Bhakti Vidya Madhav Goswami Maharaj, all the same you are serving me. So humble attitude. The appearance day of Madhav Goswami Maharaj. I was in Puri 1 year. Guru was speaking, almost 10 o'clock, you go. I'm going, no, no, go, quickly go. You will have to hear Harikatha there. Oh, Madhur Goswami Maharaj. And I heard they published one life history of Madhur Goswami Maharaj. You must get 2 or 3 volumes from me. I like to read. Oh my God! How exclusively my Guru Maharaj wanted to train me, but I am monkey. I couldn't take that lesson. Now I realize the jewel gone. You must get 2-3 volumes published. I like to read life history. Come on, he is a younger god brother. A Bhakti Puri Goswami Maharaj. This way is teaching. Guru Padmama told, if you serve Madhur Goswami Maharaj, it is my service. If you serve Prabhupada, then my service. So you find in my life 2 cases. When at all I am bound to do service, Guru Maharaj gone, I was drawn to service Madhur Goswami Maharaj. I went to Chaitanya Math, Mool Math. It's a rare case. They don't allow anybody to speak. Anybody to speak. Until and unless you have their link. But they allow me. I was so lucky man to speak all about, to speak Harikatha there in Natamandir, Abhidharan Natamandir in front of Prabhupada. So lucky. Penniless beggar I am. How lucky. So this way Guru Maharaj never speak. Don't go to Siddhar Goswami Maharaj. Don't go to Kesava Goswami. Never speak. Because they know the Tattva is one and a single. If I am going to make any mistake, whole problem can come on me and my followers. A whole society can burn off. Then not going to misguide. So this way you see, first of all, you'll have to understand his own position. The Sarupena Vyavasthiti Iti Mukti. This way, I like to go back to the original point of original point of Srila Madhavendra Puripad. Because without any link from Madhavendra Puripad, even Gauranga Mahaprabhu want to kick me out. Yeah. Go out. If I am going to deny the link of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, then Mayadevi can kick me and throw me in Maya. If I am going to link, break the link, Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, Kesava Goswami Maharaj, Goswami Maharaj, Kesava Goswami Maharaj using, I can show you Harikatha. Direct Harikatha of Kesava Goswami Maharaj. Come on, this is a Guru Godfather. How love they have. Speaking in Harikatha, my Godfather, Goswami Maharaj, going to foreign country, making so nice preaching, all starring the whole world. Kesava Goswami Maharaj speaking. My Godfather. Prabhupada wanted to speak. Prabhupada wanted to speak. You already spoke before. That from your Sridhar Goswami Maharaj is the number one preacher in Gauriya, our Saraswat Gauriya Sampradaya. How I can break this Siddhanta? Prabhupada spoke. Prabhupada give one title to them. Someone doing some problem, maybe they are not Nitya Parsad, they can do some problem. They can do some problem, they are not Nitya Parsad, they are making some problem too, because in the way of that ultimate goal, which is so topmost goal, there is always Maya. I can give you one example. When Amrita was there, after churning the whole ocean, then Amrita was there. How much fighting was there behind this Amrita? You should understand this point. You should understand that you should not criticize anybody. If there is topmost goal, quite natural this. If there is no topmost goal, no fighting. You show me, in a big jewelry shop, how much customer coming in a day? Maybe 1 or 2. To take on diamond costing 70 lakhs. You can so. But in the, you know, grocery shop, give me chal, give me rice, give me dal, give me this, poppy seed. These are always speaking. So much customer. But in there, in a jewelry shop, maybe in a day, 5-10 customer coming or not. So if there is 12 piece, then you cannot expect thousands of people to come. Not possible. Not possible. When Siddhar Gopanpa, Siddhar Gosimha is going to leave his body, I like to go grow your lost faith. I am going to help you to grow your lost faith in Guru Vaishnava, to restore. That's why I am speaking, before speaking him, making background. Paramba Siddhar Gosimha is going to leave his body within 1 or 2 days. Guru Padma with, you know, coming with Prachar Party, Chaitanya Gauri Mat. And Guru Maharaj crying inside heart. Who is speaking inside my Guru Maharaj? That your godbrother Siddhar Maharaj. Siddhar Maharaj also junior godbrother, not senior. Madhur Rasa Seva Maharaj also, much before Gurudev came. Still so humble attitude. From train, they ultimately come by a long distance and then come to coming Mayapur. Then after that, when they drop in Navadip Dham, Guru Maharaj crying inside heart, you all can go, I can drop in Saraswat Math because I like to, I think something happened, going to happen. Maharaj, fast you go, change your clothes, take rest, you are no. I can go, surely some problem going to happen. I can go fast to my God brother. He's going to meet Siddhar Maharaj. Really so. Siddhar Maharaj sick, lying in bed. Guru Padma paying dandavat and crying. And crying heavily. Oh Siddhar Maharaj, you are going to leave us. You are going to leave us. You are going to leave us, please. Crying like child. Bhakti Pumat Puri Goswami Maharaj crying this way. You see the mood of a Vaishnava. Try to understand the mood of a pure Vaishnava. When Siddhar Goswami Maharaj grown, Guru Padmanabha like crying like a child. Like a child is, nobody can stop him crying. There is a mood. I cannot upset the whole system. Because all my parampara, all my link, all, whole Vaishnava society in the world, blood link is same, spiritual link is same. I love everybody, I have no enmity with anybody, with nobody. I love them, they are my God brother, they are my God brother. Why should I? But Siddhanta, to rectify Siddhanta, is the order of Guru Varga. I must do it. So this is the mood of Guru Vaishnava. A feeling of separation. Why I am describing all this thing? To go on to this final point. Why? Same question was asked by Mahaprabhu in front of Rai Ramananda. Dukkher modde kon dukkho hai guru tara? Which is the heaviest pain in the life, grief? That's why I am very clear, like scientific way I am making background, to prove, like mathematics. Finally, I am making all mathematics and finally going to say, you see the answer? That's why I am making a big round figure, to prove. Dukkher modde kon dukkho hai guru tara? Vaishnava viraha vina dukkha nahi aro. Radhamanam singing, Prabhu, separation of Vaishnava is most painful. Right you are. Right you are. That's why I am speaking. If you cannot understand the painful situation of a Guru Vaishnava, why aprakita dukkha, aprakita pain, how I can go to the topics of Madhavendra, so exalted, so top. He's feeling Mathur Viraha. Then you can say Maharaj is Sahajiya, without making any background, jumping into Raganuga Bhajan. You have no scope. I cannot allow you to run here and there. I can beat you, I can chide you. Whatever I need, I can do you, because I love you all my children. I have my right. So, you see, there I can come to the point, what a heavy, painful situation there in the life of Madhavendra Puripad. His feeling, so strong feeling of separation. What kind of feeling? Ai dundyadhanadai mathuranad kadavalakasahidayam tadaluk kataram daito brahmanti kinkaromiham. What I can do, Prabhu? I am helpless. My end perdition coming, I cannot bear anymore. Prabhu speaking at all. It is Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami speaking first. At all this is a feeling coming in the heart of Radharani, at all came. Radharani speaking, hey Mathuranath, I think there is no time. I am going to die now and then. You can come back, you can give some consolation, but any amount of consolation is just appropriate to cool down my heart, my burning heart. Okay, you can come and discover my dead body. Hey Lalita, you can take my dead body and hang in the trees. Don't burn and don't throw into Jamuna. Krishna can at all come and discover Radha. You understand? What is the deep feeling? Asahaya can make nice philosophy in front of you to cheat you. Hai dindyardhanadhi maturanath kadavalaka shahidayan tadaluk katram daito brahmanti kim karamiham. What I can do? I am in last position. At all if I am going to show your lotus feet, then you can protect us. Otherwise, death is inevitable. Surely we are going to die. Nobody can protect us. Because a feeling of separation, you can think one kind of philosophy. I know 100%. You have that kind of feeling. You can think it's maybe one kind of philosophy. Not philosophy. It is not philosophy, direct feeling. I can give one example of one Baba in Vrindavan from Nandagram, 18 kilometers away. One Baba, Babaji Maharaj was there. He was doing nice bhajan. One day so many devotees coming and requesting Babaji Maharaj. Babaji Maharaj, we are going to take darshan of different pilgrimage like Dwaraka, there you can go, you must go with us. Very plain-hearted. Okay, I can go. He don't like to go. Devotees, they are requesting. Okay, I can go. I have no money actually. Okay, no problem. Money is not a problem. Babaji Maharaj going. Going to Dwaraka, here they are all. After that, coming back and taking some special tilak here. Current tilak, you know, current tilak. Some ink is there, put current. Then you can permanent tilak. It's all sahajya they are doing. You should not do it. Coming back in front of his Sikshaguru. Sikshaguru, what is there? How you have fallen? Fallen? Where you been? I went to Dwaraka. Dwaraka? Now Radharani, you cannot follow Radharani anymore. You are not falling from this track. You see the accurate Siddhanta. You are going to put this tilak, this tilak. Radharani, you are not in the line of Radharani anymore. I am not in Radharani line? No. We cannot accept you. Then and there, he running to his bhajan kutir and crying like a mad, oh, close the door without water, without prasadam, crying, oh Radharani, I have done some mistake. How I can reach your lotus feet? I cannot bear your separation. The separation of Raganuga Das Goswami, no? Raganuga Das Goswami, I am going to die if you are not going to come and protect me. Raganuga Das Goswami, our previous Acharya. Raganuga Das Goswami crying. Hey Dayamahi, you are showing mercy to Krishna. Also, you should show mercy to us also. tavaiva smi, tavaiva smi, na jivami tayang vina, iti vijnayo devi, nayo mam tavacharanantikam. Oh Devi, I am going to just now and then, I am going to die. Please take me near your lotus feet. I like to reach. Raghunath Das Goswami speaking. Surely no, I am yours. I am you. Tabaivasmi, na jivami tvangvi, I am not going to live without you. If you are not going to save me, be sure 100% I am going to die. Anytime. You see the feeling, you can break your heart, you cannot go back to your country to get bad association. How you can get? You have no scope. You are getting so big association. That association cannot allow you to do bad association again. That is called satsanga, foolish. That is called actually satsanga. After that, I feel not necessary. Srila Bhakti Pumapuri Goswami Maharaj giving me so highest association. After that, I don't feel necessary to go here and there like a mad. No. Here is the mood of Raghunath Das Goswami. Our previous Acharya, Prayojan Tattva Acharya, he is feeling crying this way. Now, that Babaji Maharaj, he is crying, fasting, without word and crying. Radhe, Radhe. After that, after some days, Vrajavasis become very annoyed. What problem can be there? Kutia is not open. Babaji Maharaj, already we saw him inside. What he is doing inside Bhajan Kutir? They are knocking the door. No response. From inside lock. They break and find that from leg up to this point already burnt up in fire. Only this much. Harinam going on. Up to this point already burnt up. Converted into, you know, ash. Can you realize? You cannot believe. I know. You cannot believe I know 100%. But I can show you direct. I can take you that death spot. I've been there, na? In Suryakunda here, then different forest. I can take you there and show. You don't know. You think bhajan is very playing. You are making a game. You don't understand the seriousness of bhajan. Be careful. Now I can come back to this point of Madhavendra Puripad. What kind of strong feeling Madhavendra Puripad having? Mathura Nath Krishna gone. What is the feeling? It is the feeling of Radharani. Somehow came in the heart of Madhavendra Puripad. He is speaking the speech of Radharani. Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami ji. At all Radharani was bound to speak that way, that somehow by her mercy coming, appearing this word. Madhavendra Puripad crying. Direct feeling. He is in Braja. And Mathura Nath Krishna gone, a feeling, deep feeling of separation. You cannot leave. This feeling, deep feeling, after that speaking, Oi Dindyaru Nath, we heard you are most merciful, but now how you are going to show this kind of, you know, attitude, leaving us, you gone there long way in Mathura. How we can leave? You are not going to think that how we can live. While going, you promise that you are going to come back, but we don't think you are going to come back. We are actually poor village lady, gopi. We have no education, nothing. There you can get nice gopi. They are very educated in different, you know. Mathura, they are educated, they are gopis. We are not, educated. What kind of seva we can render, do for you? Maybe for this reason you gone. They are speaking gopikas this way. But actually, those gopikas, they are not educated. Topmost educated. They are more educated than Krishna. Really so, yes. Krishna is not educated. In Brajadham, we speak Gwariya, coward boy. You know, we speak this way. We speak all rough words for Krishna, out of love. You are Gwariya, no brain you have, actually. Hello. And Radharani, topmost educated. And those Gopikas, they are also educated, topmost educated. But still, they are expressing this kind of mood. They don't know scriptural analysis, they don't know. Yes, they know. All education, all everything coming from Radharani. Even Krishna going to get education from Radharani, ultimately. Krishna speaking this way. Radharani is my master. Master? Yes, it's my master. Radhikar, Prem, Guru, Ami Shishya not, Jakhon Jaiche Nachai, Nachiye Udbhat. Krishna speaking himself. I can prove that how Prema of Radharani is a Guru. Mean Radharani is the feature of Prema? Radharani is a Guru? Radhikar, Prem, Guru, Ami Shishya not, I am disciple of Radharani. Whenever Radharani, hey, dance! Then according to his gesture, I am dancing. I have no personality. All personality gone if Radharani gone. All personality gone if Radharani missing, then Krishna is losing his personality. Krishna speaking this way. So long as Radharani is there, then I am Madan Mohan. Radha Sange Jada Bhati Tadeva Madan Mohana Annatha Vishya Mohopi Madan Mohita. So long as Radharani is there in my left side, then I am Madan Mohan. But when Radharani is leaving me, then I am Madan Mohito, aprakito kama going to grasp me like a whale. Whale, you know? Whale in the sea. Whale going to catch. I'm going to die. This is the mood of Radharani. It is the mood of Krishna. So you should understand the gravity of this, you know, of this Raganuga Bhajan, Rupanuga Bhajan. So high thoughts. You can, when after infinity period, if I can reach, Paramahansa Siddhartha Goswami is crying and speaking. When I can touch Ujjal Nilmani, I don't know. I don't know when I can touch the Ujjal Nilmani, so heavy. I am a fallen soul. Siddhartha Goswami is speaking this way. Whereas I am a foolish, I take the endeavor to run into fire. Follow. Siddhartha Goswami. Oh, I don't know which life I can have the scope to touch. Oh, so high. If all secrecy is open to all, then why Goswamis, they took decision to keep all secret topics of this Raganuga Bhajan books into Samadhi, Granta Samadhi. Jiva Goswami Pad, the topmost Tathajaya took decision. In this 14 verse, in the universe, nobody can understand the love of Krishna. They can make ugly meaning. So better we can put all books into Samadhi. They don't allow. How I can say it is open to all? How I can say open to all? Whereas you are not going to maintain your purity of your bed. You cannot maintain your purity of your bed. A Paramahansa can sleep in a bed and get up and start bhajan. So much purity there. Never their bed is contaminated. So pure, so, because their heart inside heart Krishna is there. They can get up and put some water, Ganga, and start it now, Harinam. But as the Acharya, our big Acharya, they show us, no, you have to take bath. Take bath and start Hari Bhajan. So this way Guru Varga never teach us the way of Sahajya. They never teach us. So Madhavendra Puripad speaking this way, I am in the feeling of Radharani. See, if I think that Radharani and all Gopikas, they are not educated, they are speaking this way. No, they are knowing everything. They don't know that Krishna is the Supreme Lord. Maharaj, they know. They know. Then the Rasa Tattva, they cannot get established in Rasa Tattva. If they know that Krishna is Super Soul, Almighty, you know, that is against Rasa Tattva. Then our Jiva Goswami is giving this solution. Come on, man. All Gopikas, they are highly educated, topmost. Even they can give treatment to Uddhav. They can give treatment to Krishna. I can come on these topics tomorrow. How they teach Uddhava. But still, they are speaking. Yes. Jiva Goswami, I can give you evidence. They know everything. That He is Super Soul, Almighty Supreme Lord. But then, Nakali Gopika Nandano Bhavan Akhila Dehinam Antarat Madrik. You know, they know. We know it for sure. Gopika speaking, we know it for sure. You are not the son of Gopika. You are actually Akhila Dehinam Antarat Madrik. You are Super Soul, Paramatma. Then how they get love for Him? Prema? But that is the exclusive case. Jiva Goswami, they know everything. All Tattva Gyan there. But still, it is equal to not knowing the Tattva Gyan. Tattva Gyan is there, but in so passive form, kept, so that Rasa Tattva, they cannot come out and disturb the Rasa Tattva. Follow? Their Tattva Gyan there, already there. Already there, full Tattva Gyan. But Tattva Gyan has no power to touch that Rasa Tattva. Rasa Tattva is so influential, so powerful, that they are staying down and Rasa Tattva going to show their magic spell, prema. It is just equal to not staying. It is just equal to as if not staying, but still there. Krishna don't know. Krishna don't know that He is Supernova. But still, in Vrindavan Dham, when Krishna playing with Gopikas and Vrajavasis, He shows like human activities. Father speaking, my boy, Koka, can you get my chapal? Yes. Going and getting the chapal in the head. This cannot carry the chapal. Small boy, here you are. This is the mood of Krishna. Krishna like to love you. Krishna like to serve you. You like to put some allegation against Guru Vaishnava and Krishna. You don't know heart of Krishna. I can prove how Uddhava took lesson, how Krishna took lesson from those Gopikas. They are knowing all Tattva, 100%. But still, as if it is just equal to not knowing. It's staying Tattva Gyan, knowing or not knowing, same. Because the prema is overflowing character. Prema is going to make show their magic spell of madness, craziness, madness. They cannot remember. Krishna says, I don't know. You are like human being speaking. Ballaji Maharaj like human being, small boys. Yes, it's a must. Ami ho na jani, na jane gopigon. Those gopika don't know. And I also don't know, have no information of what is going on among us, Leela. Then who knowing? You are Supreme Lord, Infinity World, you are not knowing? But I don't know. Amiyo nanani najana gopikon. There's gopikas, they also know what is happening. A mad is so mad. Mad is mad. You know, this prema has some magic spell that we are actually without any information, everything happening. Really? Who knows then? But Jogamaya arranging everything. Jogamaya. All done by Jogamaya according to the desire. According to the desire of Krishna, Jogamaya arranging situation in such a way so the Leela Rasa can overflow. Follow. It is the duty of Jogamaya. Jogamaya giving time and situation. But this material time is not applicable there. Material time factors not applicable there. Or prakito time there. Past, present and future you can calculate. What time, Maharaj? How long you are speaking? 2 hours, 10 minutes. But that time is not applicable there. Foolish. A prakita samaya. Also, I can prove mathematically that you have also no clear conception about your, you know, present. You have any clear conception about present tense? You give me? You have any conception about present tense, you give me? I can give you scientific evidence. If I see the watch, tuck, 1 second gone, fraction of second gone. Meaning every fraction of second I am going to lose my present. Then how you can say I am present? 1 second gone from my life means it is indicating my past. Try to understand. 1 second, tuck, gone. That means I am going to approach my death, 1 second advance towards death. Like in the spring, you can find all trees and creepers going to throw their old leaves in winds. You are so foolish, you cannot realize. You are going to leave, you are going to lose one by one days, like falling leaf on the ground. You are tending towards death, you foolish, you don't understand. You have no realization, that's why you are playing like a child with fire. Like spring, all. You have no conception about present tense. Even every fraction of second, I am touching past. What is present then? No clear conception of present tense. But if you someday, by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, if you can reach that eternal world, then you can understand, oh really Maharaj, now you understand, eternal present, oh. Direct realization is possible only by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava and Bhagavan. If Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur is going to give me direct realization, then I can speak out something to indicate. If you have your capacity, you can catch. In Vrindavan, after Bandara, they're speaking, Lutna hai to luto nahi to phuto. Radharani ka Bandara khula hai. Radharani ka Bandara khula hai. Lutna hai to luto nahi to phuto. If you want to take more, or you go back. Go away. In Vrindavan, those are joking mood, they are speaking. So, day by day, 1 or 2, 3 days left, actually I am very crying, I cannot explain properly what to do. I am giving just indication, so that you can at least realize some positive points. What is the gravity of this prema? What is the feeling of Radharani? Actually, Radharani is speaking in a very loveful mood, with deep, you know, pain, that now you've gone to Mathura leaving us, and because we are not qualified. There you can get all educated gopikas, they can serve you more nice way, maybe for the reason, what to do. But you should think that we are going to die. What we can do? 1 fraction of second, Juga itam nimeshena prachakshushvabrishe itam sunna itam jagata sarvam govinda virahena me. It's a feeling of Madhavendra Puripad. Who saw? Supreme Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But that time Madhavendra Puripad, when took birth, that time Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was not there. Who told you? Foolish. Who told you? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was not. 100% Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared inside his heart. That's why he was bound to feel that way. Though apparently you can see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was not manifesting his, but still, eternal presence of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming into the heart of Radha Govinda Milita Vigyoha, submission and crying. That's why he is looking the direct feeling of Radharani, direct feeling of Gauranga. Ooh. So painful situation of Gauranga. So Madhavendra was expressing. That is why, because inside Gauranga, both Krishna and Radharani, both there. That's why we are getting this kind of feeling. Excellent, which was not available there in Dwapar Yug. Exceptional thing, which is impossible. That kind of feelings also shown in this Gaur Leela. Why? A special exception. Radha Govinda Milita Thanu. That's why you see Madhavendra Puripad feeling that way. Why? Because Gauranga, golden complexion, appear inside your heart to give you inspiration to propagate Raganuga. Ultimately, I am coming, but you have to make clear the road. Any important personality coming before that, all security force coming, yes, going to clean the road first. Rani Elizabeth going, all squad, security squad going. Oh, my God, so big. Security force. So they are coming first, and after gone, coming later. Who? After that coming, all our Narottama Thakur, Srinivasaji, Ramchandra Govi, all coming. They are coming to give the impression of what Leela Prabhu done. You don't understand, that's why. With a deep feeling, Madhavendra Puripad crying now, as if the feeling of Radharani going to touch his heart. As if the feeling of Radharani going to touch his heart is speaking that way. With a feeling of very painful, feeling of separation. He is speaking. Now you've gone to Mathura. Now they can serve you more better than us. But you are not going to think for a moment that we are going to die without looking you for the fraction of sake. Same feeling. Spoken by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Sunnaitam jagat sarvam govinda virahename. Sunnaitam jagat sarvam. Mean? Sunnaitam jagat sarvam mean? Whole world I find vacant. Whole world I find vacant. Nothing is there. Sunnaitam jagat sarvam govinda virahename. This is the feeling of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. If today this film is going to touch you, I'm sure that you can survive in bhajan line. Otherwise, Maya can catch your cloth and push you away. Don't try to take any association. At all, you will have to do good association. Both, I cannot approve you. After hearing Hari Katha, in Vyasasan, I can promise you, I can arrange some good for you, but I cannot arrange. Because you are busy with asasanga. I know very well. Mentally or physically. You will have to take resolution. I can do or die. That kind of resolution there in the life of Guru Bhargava. Also, I like to grow that kind of feeling. If at all by the mercy of Guru Bhargava coming to touch my heart, Jeva mai se kita sauhidartha jane shudehantaravartikeshu gehe sujayatma jarati matsu na priti yukta javadartha shaloke vanchakalpaturusya ke pasindibhavacha pasitanang pavana bhavishna bhyo namo.